What's up, guys? It's Lindsay, and I am back for another video. Oh my gosh, I am so excited to finally show you today's haul. I am currently filming this on June 15th. This haul was from the 2nd of June. I'm a little bit behind on filming videos again, but this video is gonna be so incredible because finally, I walked out of the bins with like 40 plus items. I have not walked out of the bins with 40 plus items in a while. I don't know when the last time it was, honestly. With that being said, because there are so many items here, and I don't know about anyone else, but I am someone that prefers shorter videos over longer videos. So what I'm gonna do is this video is going to be filmed in two parts. That way it is shorter content for you to be able to see. Let's go ahead, jump into this haul, show you what I got. This is part one. Let me know what your favorite item ends up being down below. So let's go ahead and get into it. The first thing, this is a vintage Olga brand. This is a size 34. I have sold Olga in the past, and this is a great like vintage brand, vintage like slip lingerie, whatever you want to call it, thing to sell. But this is just like lace trimmed, and it's got like this lace detail on the side with like kind of a slit. And then I got this vintage Onyx Knight made in USA, size extra large. As you can tell, it's like very, very glittery, and it might be hard to see, but the glitter is actually like silver and pink. It is an extra large, which is a great size, and I think it does run slightly cropped. Okay, this, man, I was so excited when I found this. The funny thing is, so this is obviously a vintage, it's a vintage dress with like a asymmetrical cut, I think is what you would consider that. It's by the brand M Collection. I believe it was a size medium. It does have like this drapey neck like people are wearing right now. And then it's got like this crisscross back. Super cute. The funny thing is that when I grabbed this, it had a huge yellow stain. Huge, I'm talking obvious huge yellow stain, like right down here in the white part. Thankfully, if anyone has ever used it, but LA is totally awesome, which can be bought at like the dollar store or Dollar Tree or whatever. That is pretty much what I use for all yellow stains like that. I sprayed it on, I set it out in the sun, and the stain is completely gone. You would never even know that there was a stain, and this dress is literally like in perfect condition. And then here is another one. So this is not tagged, so I haven't tried to do like a Google image search to see who this is by originally, but it definitely is vintage just based off the fabric that's like used under like the neck flap. This is just like a little button front little mini dress, and honestly, this is like so Reformation-esque. It does look like it had ties on the back. The ties are gone, but this is so, so cute. Perfect for summer. And a brand that I've talked about being hesitant to pick up, this is Free People. And the tag down on the side says that it's a medium. So this is a medium, and it is a very oversized medium. But it's kind of like a tunic, high-low tunic style. This is a Alice and Olivia size 12. Alice and Olivia, again, is not necessarily a high seller anymore, but this is just like a simple little black dress, and it's got like this mesh, sheer mesh down at the bottom. So when I got home, I think I kind of figured out what happened with this. I purchased this way out of the bin. So I saw this, and it's like this lace cardigan is what it looks like. Like it looks like just an open front lace cardigan thing. Only thing I could not figure out is why it had a keyhole back and it had the button here. It just seemed odd to me that it was that way. Well, then when I started to analyze it, it looked like someone had actually cut this. So I think what happened is this was like actually a dress. I don't know if you'll be able to tell, but you can see that it's uneven, and you can see that this was probably together and they cut it, but they cut it to make him like an open cardigan, which is fine because someone is still going to buy it this way, but there's no brand. It's pretty uneven all the way down, but it is definitely like based on just the look of it, this is gonna be no problem, a $15 to $20 sale, easy. This is another vintage brand, I believe. Taka, I've never seen it, so I'm not sure, in a size 4. Knee-length, like, pink fuchsia skirt. This was debatable. I wasn't really sure on grabbing this one, but I think when I looked up the comps before I left, it seemed like these sell moderately quickly, so I was like, okay, well, maybe I will just grab this. This is, I'm assuming it's vintage, but it might not be. Amanda Stewart in a size large, made in India. This is just like a little tiered maxi dress with super bright colors. I mean, this is something that is so boho, and I could just see someone wearing this at like a festival or something. This looks like everyone's grandma's couch, but this is SL Petite. This is a size 10, and this is gonna look real frumpy, real frumpy, but you know that someone could really like make this their own and really like DIY if they really wanted it. This is a vintage JCPenney, size medium. Here is the JCPenney tag. It's kind of like a paper tag. This lace trim, I think someone must have cut the back. I don't think the back was this way because it looks like it was cut around and then kind of like up here it's kind of like uneven. But this is a light pink slip type thing. I think maybe they might have cut it down at the bottom too, so it's like a high low cut. This is cool because I don't think I've ever found this brand in slips. I have found a lot of slips, but I don't think I've found this one. This is a Gotham gold stripe, and I think this is a size 34. My guess is, based off the tag, this is probably like 60s, 70s. I haven't really looked into it that deep yet. This is so darling. It's got this like ruffled edge. It does have a flaw on the side here, but since it's under the armpit, I don't really think that's gonna make a difference. And it's got the same thing on this side. It's just kind of unraveling. Yet another pink thing. The pink was insane on this trip. Vintage Grace Element in a size 18W, and it is 100% linen, which linen is one of those, you know, kind of specialty fabrics that, you know, normally you can sell it for a little bit higher, but it's just this super cute, like, pleated pink floral skirt that hits probably at just about the knee or a little shorter. And then, like I said in my last video, Tommy Bahama is a tried and true brand for me. Again, this was one of the ones that I picked up in the first, within the first probably 10 minutes of me being there. Just a Tommy Bahama red quarter zip sweater. Okay, this is something that I bought for the intent of my Seattle sports show, which you can see the clothes down here at the bottom. This is a, I assume vintage, it might not be, but it's maybe Y2K. This is a size large, and this is a Washington State University hoodie, and then it's just got the cougars on the side here. And then, okay, so then I came across this, and I saw it, and I was like, oh, that's cool, like, a corset. I knew at one point these were doing, like, really well, and so I was gonna grab it regardless, but it's got, like, I don't know what you call this. It's almost like a velour, kind of, but not really. And then it's just got these studs down the front, and it's sheer on the back. But then I noticed that as I was going through my cart that this was actually new with tags, and it is Victoria's Secret in a size medium. This might only sell for 15, 20 bucks. I have no idea. So we will find out when the time comes. These are kind of insane. And this is the wrong season probably to be buying these, but these are These are the brand MNML in a size 31, and these are men's. I never have seen this brand, but I saw this tag and I thought, man, that looks kind of expensive. I'm gonna look it up. But also, the jeans themselves just look kind of expensive. So these are the jeans. So it's bedazzled with a skeleton all the way down the front and the back. They retail for like $80 or $90, so they don't retail for that high. I mean, I don't even know if these were ever worn. These, I think maybe I'll only be able to get like $50 at the most, but they are so heavy. I mean, I might be able to get more. We'll just have to wait and see on those. Okay, so that is gonna be everything for part one. Let me know what your favorite item was down below. We still have so much to get through for part two, but I will just leave it there with the skeleton jeans as being the cliffhanger. Other than that, please like this video if you found this portion of the haul interesting. Please stay tuned for part two. Hopefully it'll be coming out in a decent amount of time and I won't be making you wait too long. But other than that, thank you for watching. I will see you in the next video, and stay tuned. Bye.